हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू नाइन्थ पार्ट ऑफ द वीडियो ऑफ आवर सीरीज 100 मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस फॉर टीजीटी पीजीटी एमए इंग्लिश एंट्रेंस। एक पार्ट तक के वीडियोस का लिंक आप डिस्क्रिप्शन में देख सकते हैं एंड प्लीज डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब द चैनल एंड टेक डाउन ऑल दी नोट्स फैक्ट्स एक्सप्लेनेशन एंड डू नॉट रन जस्ट आफ्टर नोइंग द राइट आंसर। नो द डिटेल्स बिहाइंड इट, दैट इज द वे यू विल बी एबल टू रिटेन इट फॉर अ लॉन्गर टाइम एंड प्लीज डू अ थरो स्टडी। लेट अस बिगिन विद द क्वेश्चन नंबर 81। क्वेश्चन नंबर 81, हु इन्वेंटेड एंड पॉपुलराइज द फ्रेज पोएटिक जस्टिस। द करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन नंबर सी, राइमर। पोएटिक जस्टिस इज अ लिटरेरी डिवाइस इन विच अल्टीमेटली वर्च्यू इज रिवॉर्डेड एंड वाइस पनिश्ड। English drama critic Thomas Rymer coined the phrase in The Tragedies of the Last Age Considered. The Tragedies of the Last Age Considered, please note down, जो कि 1678 का एक टेक्स्ट है, and he used it to describe how a work should inspire proper moral behavior in its audience by illustrating the triumph of good over evil. Poetical justice demanded that those of good characters were rewarded and that the evil were punished. Next question, question number 82. Complete the sentence, Milton's Areopagitica concerned with liberty of human rights, liberty of press, freedom of humanity or freedom of politics. So, one tip here, do not just run after the right answer. Right answer को ध्यान से सुनिए, उसमें कुछ ऐसे facts, कुछ ऐसे detail, कुछ ऐसी dates हो सकती हैं, जो कि आपको further किसी question में काम आ सकती हैं. तो यहाँ पर हमारा correct answer है liberty of प्रेस। जॉन मिल्टन्स एरियोपेजिटिका, अ स्पीच ऑफ मिस्टर जॉन मिल्टन फॉर द लिबर्टी ऑफ अनलाइसेंस्ड प्रिंटिंग टू द पार्लियामेंट ऑफ इंग्लैंड इज अ 1644। डेट याद रखिएगा 1644। प्रोस ट्रैक दैट अपोजेस लाइसेंसिंग एंड सेंसरशिप, लिबर्टी ऑफ प्रेस इट प्रमोट्स। जॉन मिल्टन ने पब्लिश किया था इसको 1644 में टू प्रोटेस्ट एन ऑर्डर इशूड बाय पार्लियामेंट द प्रीवियस ईयर requiring government approval and licensing of all published books. Next question, what is soliloquy? An actor's secret through uttered aloud secret speech, an actor's speech not to be heard by audience, or an actor's speech meant for other characters also. Option number A is the right answer, soliloquy. An actor's secret thought uttered aloud, a speech in a play in which a character who is alone on the stage speaks his or her thought aloud, the act of speaking thoughts aloud in this way is called soliloquy. Next question, question number 84. When was the first collection of Shakespeare's play known as the first folio published? The correct answer is option number A, 1623. Shakespeare's first collection of plays known as the first folio was published in 1623. In the first published collection of Shakespeare play produced 7 years after his death, its title is Mr. William Shakespeare's Comedies, Histories and Tragedies, and it groups his plays into those categories, comedies, history and tragedies, for the first time. The text was collated by two of Shakespeare's fellow actors and friends, John Hurmage and Henry Condell, who edited it and supervised the printing. They appear in a list of the principal actors who performed in Shakespeare's play alongside Richard Burbage, Will Kemp and Shakespeare himself. So, aap naam yaad rakhiyega, kaun kaun se fellow actors the? John Hurmage and Henry Condell. So, this is how the first folio looks like, and these are the name of those two personalities who published it, John Hurmage and Henry Condell. Next question, question number 85. What could be the tragic flaw in Hamlet? Noble Oedipus complex, vaulting ambition, or inability to act in time? Option number D here is the correct answer. The tragic flaw, जो कि माना जाता है कि एक प्रोटैगनिस्ट की, एक सेंट्रल कैरेक्टर की पर्सनालिटी में कोई फ्लॉ है जिसकी वजह से उसका खुद का डाउनफॉल होता है। द ट्रैजिक फ्लॉ इन हैमलेट इज हैमलेट्स इनएबिलिटी टू एक्ट टू अवेंज हिज फादर्स डेथ इन टाइम। ऑल्दो इट मस्ट बी सेड दैट ही हैज वैलिड कंसर्न्स दैट प्रिवेंट हिम नोइंग हाउ टू एक्ट, एज ही मेक्स क्लियर व्हेन ही डिस्कसेस द नेचर ऑफ गोस्ट्स दैट कैन बी सेंट टू एंटैंगल एंड एंट्रैप एन इनोसेंट इन एक्शंस लीडिंग टू द पनिशमेंट ऑफ हेल। Hence, here option D, inability to act in time. He could not take the proper decisions in time. That was his basic flaw. Next question, question number 86. In which play Shakespeare has presented a royal criminal? The correct answer, option number C, Richard III. Shakespeare has presented a royal criminal in his historical play Richard III. Richard III is a play by William Shakespeare. It was probably written around 1593. And it is labeled as a history in the first folio and is usually considered one. But it is sometimes called a tragedy too. Next question. Question number 87. In which play of Shakespeare does Adam appear? The correct answer is option number B, As You Like It. Adam, the elderly former servant of Sir Roland de Bois, having witnessed Orlando's hardships, Adam offers not only to accompany his young master into exile, but to fund their journey with the whole of his modest life savings. He is a model of loyalty and a devoted service. Adam is kindly old servant, rumored to have been played by Shakespeare himself in As You Like It when it was performed for the first time. Next question, question number 88. Who asked how many children had Lady Macbeth? Out of these options, you have to select one right answer. How many children had Lady Macbeth? An essay in the theory and practice of Shakespeare criticism. L.C. Knights, that is the correct answer. L.C. Knights, Lionel Charles Knights, who was an English literary critic and authority on Shakespeare and his period. His essay, How Many Children Had Lady Macbeth, jo ki 1933 ka ek essay hai. This essay is a classic in modern criticism. Hence, it was L.C. Knights who had asked how many children Lady Macbeth had. Next question, question number 89. Who considered romanticism liberalism in literature? Wordsworth, Plato, Theodore Watt, Stinton, or Victor Hugo? The correct answer is option number D, Victor Hugo. It was Victor Hugo who has considered romanticism a liberalism in literature. Hence, option here will be option number D. Victor Hugo defines romanticism as liberalism in literature. I think that there is much validity in Hugo's statement. The fundamental perspectives of liberalism are found in romanticism. For example, liberalism stresses on individual rights, is very close intellectually to the idea of placing primacy on the subjective experience. So liberalism is actually close to romanticism. Next question, question number 90. This is the last question of this video and rest of the 10 questions we will cover in next part. I hope aap logon ne previous 8 parts zarur dekhe hain, then only you will be benefited by this series. How many sonnets are addressed to W.H. by Shakespeare? 125, 124, 122 or 126? The correct answer is option number D, 126. शेक्सपियर जी जिन्होंने कि 154 टोटल सोनेट्स लिखे थे, शेक्सपियर रोट 154 सोनेट्स इन ऑल एंड द फर्स्ट 126 आर एड्रेस्ड टू अ यंग मैन, द लास्ट 28 आर आइदर एड्रेस्ड टू और रेफर टू अ वुमन. सो 126 हियर इज द करेक्ट आंसर. So this is the end of this part of the video. Please tell me your score now. We will soon meet with the next part. Keep studying, keep practicing. This will be your key to success. And please do not forget to share and subscribe the channel. Best of luck from my side for any kind of exam that you appear for in your life.